Hello everyone, today I'm going to pour on my first guitar on which I learned to play on, and to prepare this guitar for the pour I cleaned it with alcohol first. I also removed the strings and I taped the top. And further down the side, I used plastic. I also sanded it with a grit 220 and cleaned it with alcohol, and after that with 400 grit. And yeah, let's see how it goes. At the moment, I'm using a creamy color. I used Angel White of Lures, and I put some chocolate gold of Lures in it, a little bit, and also 2 drops of Brilliant Yellow ink. That's a irritant, that's of Eli Gem. So all the way around the side, I'm pouring this color. Yeah, and we will see how it goes. So also in the hole of the guitar, I put some plastic. And I have some tape around the edges that stands a little bit on top, so that my design stays on the guitar. And after a few hours, I will take it away. So it's very important that you prepare the guitar very good. So almost the whole guitar is taped and also sanded and cleaned with alcohol so that the dust is from the guitar. And now I'm pushing the resin against the tape with my steering stick. So I don't want the a white color. I wanted a little bit of off-white, a creamy color. I think that matches a little bit more with the other colors I'm using, and also with the side of the guitar and the back. So that's why I made this color. So the next color I'm going to use is the Ruby of Just Resin. Very nice metallic color, a deep red. I like that. So against the creamy color, I'm pouring the Ruby. A little bit on top of it and also next to it. And I want, if it's all whole covered with resin, I want to blend those colors into each other. I like that. Also around the hole, this color, the Ruby. And also on the bottom of the guitar in the hole, I put some plastic, because if it drips along the sides down, then I have the plastic there so that it doesn't get dirty. So I hope that will work. Next color is the copper of Stone Coat, also a very nice metallic color. Next to the Ruby. Yes, I learned to play on this guitar. I have now at the moment I have another one, and but I wanted to try it on this one first and see how it goes. Little bit of heat. And I'm using the Mastercard again. It's a little bit thicker. I like that. But if it's thicker, it needs more heat if you want to blend those colors. And then you need to watch out that you don't burn your resin. The next color is a very dark, sparkly brown, and that's the Chocolate Truffle of Color Obsession. So next to the copper, I'm pouring this color. Again, the creamy color. All the colors I'm using are listed in this video at the beginning, but also in the description box. So if you want to see that, then take a look at the description box. Also, the ruby again. And some copper of Stone Coat. Again, the Chocolate Truffle of Color Obsession. I also had some requests of the Dutch people that they wanted me to make some videos in the Dutch language. I already made one, so yeah, if you want to see that, you don't understand it, but you can see what I'm doing. I'm making some videos of the whole process from beginning until the end result. So yeah, you can check that out, but yeah, you don't understand it. It's for the Dutch people. So I'm filling in all the gaps. And now I'm putting some heat on it to blend those colors. Also try to blow that creamy color over the ruby and the copper of Stone Coat. So very carefully I try to blow and blend those colors into each other. There you see me blow the creamy color over the ruby and over the copper. I like that effect. And I'm not after cells or whatsoever, I only want to try to blend those colors. And also at the end of this video, a close-up, not the end result yet, because I need to put the strings back on, and but that's in another video. And also the table I'm working on, the coffee table, I will do that in one video, the end result of that table and the end result of this guitar. So at the end of this video, only a close-up. And then you can see if you want to, if it changes or not, and how the edges are, and if the colors blended nicely into each other, and how it sparkles. Yeah, I'm adding more cream, a creamy color along the sides. It disappears a little bit because it's a very heavy pigment. And again, I'm trying to blow the creamy color over the copper and over the ruby. That's much better. Yeah, and I'm not using this guitar anymore for playing. It will be on our wall as an art object. I'm looking at it if there is any dust in it or hairs. Or whatsoever. The torch for the air bubbles. And I do this several times. Also when it's drying, I check on it if I have new air bubbles. And then, if I have, then I'm using the torch again to remove them. Yeah, and I'm curious if the tapes comes off very easy. Again the torch. Because I look at it in several directions, and I saw some air bubbles, so I'm going to use the torch again. And again, I'm looking if there is something in it. More creamy color. Yeah, and it looks already much better than I had. So I'm very pleased. I like the colors very much. This is a very nice color combination. And especially with the cream color, it works very well with the ruby and with the brown and the copper. I like it. So I'm almost done, and then we can go to the close-up. Yeah, again, I'm looking very good if I see something in the resin, because it's not nice if there is something in it, if it's dry. Again, the torch, but because I saw some air bubbles again. But it's so difficult to get everything dust-free. I have a dust-free zone, but yeah, also there is dust in it. We have dust everywhere, so that's very difficult. But yeah. So the large bit of torching, and then we can go to the close-up. So this is how it looks now. After 2 hours I took the tape off from the top, and I let it drip over the sides, and because I had plastic there, so that doesn't matter. And yeah, after 10 hours I removed all the tape and the plastic, and now it looks this way. I'm very pleased. There are some parts I'm not totally happy about, because yeah, the edges, yeah, they are good, but yeah, not perfect. But yeah, when is something perfect? But the plastic in the hole worked very well. It dripped a little bit in it, but it got not on the bottom of the guitar. And the colors have blended nicely into each other. Also, the ruby is a very nice sparkly metallic color. I like it very much, and also the self-made cream I added works very well with the other colors. So I'm very pleased. So this one is going to be on our wall as an art piece. I'm not going to play on it anymore. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up if you like what I'm doing. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. All the links are in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!